So you have to put yourself in the shoes of your parents or your family and understand that they're genuinely concerned and worried for you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, my name is John Fontaine. Welcome back to another episode of the Islam Wise Advice to New Muslims throughout the Christmas season. For this particular video, I want to touch on a few topics regarding family. Now, of course, it really depends on the individual. But just to give you one scenario, as I mentioned, when I first came to Islam, my parents didn't know I was a Muslim. So I was living in their house. I was actually afraid to tell them that I was a Muslim because I was even financially dependent on them at that particular time because I was in a very tough situation. And I felt that if I tell my parents that they might kick me out of the house. And alhamdulillah, they didn't kick me out when they found out I was a Muslim, but they wasn't happy. They wasn't happy, and understandably they wasn't happy. And we must also understand that when our family and friends and our neighbours or whoever, when they find out that we're Muslim, that they have genuine concerns. And we must, you know, sometimes it's easy just to say, you know, Islam is true, you know, why don't you become a Muslim and all this. But in reality, we have to look at it and put ourselves in their shoes, because we was once in their shoes. And many of the new Muslims were also afraid of Islam at one point. Because it's understandable with today in the media, the way they make Islam to be an enemy and to be dangerous. It's understandable that people are scared of Islam. So you have to put yourself in the shoes of your parents or your family and understand that they're genuinely concerned and worried for you. So, you know, before Christmas time, before the festive season, you know, try and sit down with them. Explain to them, look, mom and dad, look, I've accepted Islam. You know, I've not just done this, you know, for a boyfriend or a girlfriend or for the financial or whatever. I've done this out of research. You know, I've read the Quran or I've studied Islam. I've looked into Islam and I actually am accepting Islam with knowledge. And you can sit down with them and reassure them that, look, you know, I'm not a danger. I'm not a criminal. I'm not a bad person. It's just a choice of faith that I've decided. I'm still John. I'm still whoever, but I just don't do them bad things that I used to do anymore. I don't go out to the clubs, I don't drink alcohol, I don't smoke, I don't do drugs, whatever it may be. You know, I don't have girlfriends, I don't have boyfriends, whatever it may be. You know, I'm still John, but I'm not the old John. You know, I'm a better version of myself, you know, and tell them what Islam teaches. And subhanAllah, with the run up to Christmas, they also, you know, Jesus is the focal point around the Christmas period. You can explain to them, you know, that Jesus is also a respected prophet in Islam. And he told us to actually, you know, be nice and caring and loving to our parents, to be good and just, you know, and explain to them that, look, we love Jesus, peace be upon him, but we don't celebrate Christmas. And, you know, most people will respect your wishes. They might not necessarily like it. They might, you know, wish that you was there. They might still invite you to the house. But then, you know, you have to look at what you're going to do. Now, of course, there's many different situations. And, you know, Sheikh Abdulrahim McCarthy, he's going to go into a lot more detail on the ins and outs of the details of the fiqh. But I'm just giving general advice on some of the issues. Now, you know, I really advise, first of all, sitting down with your family, trying to speak to them. Also, meet them before Christmas or maybe the day after Christmas. You know, go for something to eat. Go take them for a meal. You know, maybe in a halal restaurant. You know, take them for a meal. Show them you still have this sense of family, but you just prefer not to do it on Christmas Day. You prefer not to celebrate Christmas Day. What I found with this as well is people respect you more when you hold firm to your faith. You know, when they see Muslims who are not practicing Islam, people who may be drinking alcohol or selling drugs or whatever it may be, people know that Islam doesn't allow you to do this. So when they see you disobeying the Islamic rulings, people don't take you seriously. People think you don't have principles. So when you actually hold fast to your principles and you show them, look, I'm in business. You know, I pray 5 times a day. Actually, it's time to pray. I'm going to go and pray. You know, and you go and pray upstairs in one of the rooms or something. You know, or, you know, it's Christmas Day. We don't celebrate Christmas. Or it's Eid today. We celebrate Eid. We're having the day off work. You know, things like that. To actually stand firm to your principles. Now, I'm aware that in some certain circumstances, maybe you've not told your parents and it might even be dangerous for you. I understand. These are exceptions, you know. These are exceptions where you might not tell your parents straight away. But in most cases, most people, once you stick to your principles and explain to them, they will understand. Now, another point with family is often when we've accepted Islam, we run back home and start trying to give dawah to our family because we want them all to be a Muslim. But the problem with this is often when we've just accepted Islam, we don't have enough knowledge to convey Islam. I remember when I was trying to tell my father about Islam and looking back on it, I told him all the wrong things. I remember I was trying to explain the preservation of the Quran and all this thing, but I didn't have a clue what I was speaking about. And I probably told him the wrong information. Now, this isn't good, you know. When we're actually trying to tell people about Islam, we must make sure that what we're saying is correct, because you could have an effect on your family not coming into Islam because you give them the wrong information. So it's very important that you take that into consideration. I know I'm speaking a lot here, but there's many points. But back to the family. So the initial family, as I said, having family gatherings, having a meal, this is a good thing. But then there's different types of family gatherings. As I said, gathering specifically on Christmas Day, this is not something that we do in Islam. So you have to try to maneuver around it. Try your best as a Muslim to, you know, to keep the ties of kingship, but at the same time hold firm to your principles and know that Allah will reward you hugely for this. The other point is that sometimes throughout the Christmas period, not necessarily Christmas Day, but through the whole period, these family gatherings. Now, family gatherings are fine, but often family gatherings come with music and alcohol, and in some cases even drugs. And subhanAllah, I remember going to Christmas parties, you know, as a you know, before I was Muslim, and you know, you see children running around, there's alcohol, these drugs, these parties. And realistically, we have to really check ourselves and think about this as human beings. Are these the best places to be, really, as human beings? And they're not, you know. And we know from Islamic perspective, of course, we don't want to be in this type of environment. So don't feel shy in standing firm to your principles. You know, tell your parents, tell your family, your extended family, look, you know, this isn't my type of thing. I don't go to parties anymore. You know, why don't you come to my house in the week and I'll cook you some food, you know. So instead of going to their party, maybe you can invite your nieces or your nephews or whoever it is, you know, you can invite your family members round to your house for a meal rather than you going to the parties. This is a good way of showing that you still want to keep the ties of kinship, you still want to keep the family ties, but at the same time, you're not going to give in to your principles. So this is just some points. I'm going to leave it there for now because the video is getting quite long, but inshallah, in the next video, I'll address a few more points and gives a few more tips and advice. I hope this has been helpful. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.